Hello everyone, as part of 2D clipping we discussed how a point can be clipped, how a line can be clipped. Time clipping can be done in two ways by using two algorithms. One is Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm and Cyrus-Beck line clipping algorithm. So let's move on to another algorithm. That algorithm is used to perform polygon clipping algorithm, and the algorithm name itself is Sutherland-Hedgman polygon clipping algorithm. Polygon clipping can be done by processing the polygon vertices, all the polygon vertices as a whole, against each boundary of your clipping window. Now what happens is, we need to consider one clipping window. You need to process all the polygon edges and you need to clip that part. Let us consider you need to start with the left boundary of your clipping window. Then you need to process through all the polygon vertices. Then you need to clip that. You will be getting new vertices, and those new vertices will be clipped by the other polygon, clipping window. And after that you will be getting new vertices. And by using those vertices you need to process for other two boundaries, other two edges of your clipping window. So let me take one example. Suppose this is your clipping window. And let us consider this is your polygon. Okay, so this is your original polygon. Let me represent the edge by polygon, edge by dashed line. This is your window. This is your clipping window, and this will be your polygon. Now let us consider your clipping left boundary of your left boundary of your window. Now your image will be looking like this. After performing left clipping, the image may look like this. This is left clipping, left boundary clipping. If you perform right side, you need to process by using these vertices. The new vertices only you need to consider, and your image may look like this. This is right boundary clipping. Right? Then you need to clip on the upper side, upper boundary of your clipping window. Then your image may look like this. And if you clip, finally you need to clip the bottom window, then the clipping window will be like this. So this will be your final polygon after performing your clipping operation. So how to do that clipping, we need to follow. We have some steps to be followed how to do that. So we have some cases. The first case is case 1, where for a clipping window boundary, the one vertex will be outside the clipping boundary window and the other vertex will be inside the clipping window. Let us consider this case. This is your boundary, let us consider. Okay, now you have a case like this where, let us call this one V1 and this one V2. So one vertex will be outside and one vertex will be inside. In that case, you need to have the intersection point of this V1 and V2. Let us call that intersection point as V1 dash, and you need to store V1 dash and V2 in the memory. So in this case, you need to store V1 dash and V2, where V1 is exterior and V2 is interior. The other case, case 2. If this is the clipping window and both the lines are inside, let us consider V1, V2. That V1 and V2 both are interior to clipping window, then you need to save only V2. It is required to save only V2. Third case. this is your clipping window. You have a third case where the starting point will be inside the window and the ending point will be outside the window. Let us call V1, V2. In that case, you need to find the intersecting point. Let us call this one as V1 dash. You need to save only V1 dash. No need to save V1. So save V1 dash. And the last case, case 4, where if this is the clipping window and you have both the points exterior to your clipping window, that means V1, V2, in that case, you need to save. So this is how you have processed by using by considering one edge of your clipping boundary. You need to process the same way with the right boundary. You need to process the same way with the upper boundary. You need to perform the same operation using the lower boundary. Then you will get a final image which will be inside of your clipping window, and that is nothing but clipping of your polygon. Let us take one example and perform the operation. I'll draw the figure. The image will look like this. Let us consider this one. Your clipping window will be this one. Okay. My polygon will consist of 5 vertices. So my vertices starts from V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. Now how to process this one? So I told you we need to select one boundary. Let us consider our left boundary first. So for the left boundary, if you consider edge V1, V2. For edge V1, V2, this is interior and this is external. So you need to consider one intersecting point. Let us call that intersecting point as V1 dash. And you need to store only V1 dash as I told you. But as we are crossing for the first time, we need to store the initial value and the intersecting point. So edge V1, V1 dash. Next. For the edge V2, V3. If you consider edge V2, V3, for this one, we have one intersecting point, let us call that one as V2 dash, and you need to store V2 dash and V3. V2 dash and V3. Next, for edge V3, V4. For edge V3, V4, if you consider for this boundary, both V3 and V4 are interior, so you need to store only V4. Next, for edge V4, V5. For edge V4, V5, this is also interior, you need to store only V5. For edge V5, V1, that is also interior to your left boundary, you need to store only V1. Then you will get an image like this. Where you got this intersecting point, that is V2 dash, V3 and V4. And V5, V1, and you got one intersecting point here, that is V1 dash. This is after performing your left boundary clipping. Next, we'll see the right boundary. So, if you are performing right boundary clipping, this is your boundary you need to consider. Let us consider edge V1, V1 dash. You need to consider the new vertices. So if you consider V1, V1 dash, it is interior. So you need to say, as we are crossing for the first time, you need to say V1, V1 dash. Next, for edge, V1 dash, V2 dash, both are interior. So you need to store V2 dash. Next, for the edge, V2 dash, V3, that is also interior. You need to store V3. Next, for the edge, V3, V4, both are interior, you need to store V4. For the edge, V4, V5, this is also interior, you need to store V5. For the edge, V5, V1, that is also interior, you need to store V1. Right? This is how we need to, also after plotting this, you will get the same same image, where because we have nothing outside of this external, we'll get the same image. So let us click through bottom boundary. So bottom boundary, let us start edge v1 dash. For the bottom boundary, if you consider both v1 dash are both outside, so we need to save nothing, right? Now edge v1 dash v2 dash, if you consider, for v1 is outside and v2 dash is inside of your bottom boundary, you will have an intersecting point. Let us call that one as v1 double dash. You need to store v1 double dash v2. Next, edge v2 dash v3, as v2 dash v3 both are interior to your bottom boundary, you need to store v3. And edge v3 v4, that is also interior, you need to store v4. Edge v4 v5, that is also interior, you need to store v5. And coming to edge v5 v1, if you observe, v5 is interior and v1 is external, you need to take the intersecting point as v5 dash, you need to store v5 dash. So this is how now the image will be changing like this, where you'll have the polygon shape like this. So this is v2 dash, this is v1 double dash, this is v5 dash, v5, v4, v3. Now we are left with clipping on the upper boundary. So now we need to proceed with edge v1 double dash, v2 dash. If you consider the upper boundary, both are interior, so you need to save v1 double dash, v2 dash, because we are crossing for the first time, you need to store the initial vertex. Like edge v2 dash, v3, we need to store v3 because both are internal. Edge v3, v4, if you consider, one is internal and external, you have this case, you need to find out the intersecting point, let us call that one as v3 dash, you need to store v3 dash. Next, edge v4, v5, again one is external and this is internal, you need to select this one, let us call this one v4 dash, you need to store v4 dash, v5. And edge v5, v5 dash, both are internal, you need to store v5 dash. So after doing this, your polygon will be changed like this, the clipping. You will get an image like this, v2 dash, v3 dash, v4 dash, v5, v5 dash, and v1 double dash. Right? You need to process the edge v5 dash, v1 double dash, you need to store v1 double dash. So this is the final clipped polygon by using Sutherland Hedgeman polygon clipping window. So you need to remember, you need to process each and every boundary, and for each and every boundary you need to traverse through all the vertices, and for each traversal you need to consider new vertices only to clip through that boundary. This is how Sutherland Hedgeman polygon clipping algorithm works. Thank you.